Hello, everyone. This is Kirby.
Shadow.
Venom.
Zero.
And we are the crew of dorkFish Labs, and we're here to do a small review on Star Wars Battlefront Beta that happened this past weekend. Now, the way we're going to format this is we're going to start out talking about some of the pros of the game, then the cons, and end it with some of our highlights and our personal experiences. And do keep in mind that this was just a beta build of the game, and that things can and hopefully will change. So guys, let's go ahead and start talking about it. What'd you like about the game?
It's a good Star Wars experience. It's an updated, an updated version, I guess.
The maps are big.
Maps are big?
Yeah.
No, there's like the invisible thing that says return to battlefield.
That's in most games where you got that invisible wall. At least they marked a boundary for you.
Yeah, I mean, and honestly, that's a pretty big, at least the Hoth map that we played on. That's a huge map. It's like playing on Caspian border.
No. Once you learn where everything's at, it doesn't really feel all that big. It feels pretty linear. Like you can't really climb and move around the map. You can't really flank anybody. It's pretty much just a mash line.
Well, yeah, that was because of the game mode. Now, if they had a conquest version of that map, it's huge.
Oh yeah. Well, then they'd have to have a little bit more variety of weapons in there.
Yeah.
Because okay. Yeah, but anyways, we all kind of got that feeling of where this is leaning. I would say it's a good Star Wars experience so far. I liked all the iconic sounds that they put in there. You know, that they pretty much ripped everything, you know, straight from the movies or Lucasfilms or something like that.
They do have an excellent mix of vehicles. I did like that.
Oh yeah, that was pretty fun.
Oh, if you're playing on the Empire side.
Yeah.
The 95% success rate. I've already seen plenty of people talking about that over the weekend, how hard it is to actually lose as the Empire.
And here's the thing, I think that if they had rocket launchers for the Rebels, because you can pick up the rocket launcher, and when you do, you start just destroying the Empire. The problem is getting the damn thing. But you can also use that ion shot that they have.
Man, does that even work? I shot at some things, but I didn't really see any effect from it.
Yes. It turns your weapon, it turns all your blaster rounds into ions, so it's that little blue electricity.
Yeah, yeah.
And you shoot it at the ATSTs, it does like a little bit more damage. But don't shoot it at the AT-ATs until their thing is down, but yeah.
And they've got those satellites everywhere where you can just use them to ring the rockets or something like that. I never got
the
to
orbital
see
strikes.
Where I
finished.
Yeah, that train. Was...
The orbital strikes are nice. I think he's talking about the turrets that the Rebels are supposed to use, though. Those things are death traps.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's nice that they're on there, but they need to beef up the defense a little bit or give them a little bit more capability. Because, you know, anytime I would jump on any of those and they'd figure out that somebody was in there, you were gone in a second. And, what was kind of taking me off was the fact that people were, they were shooting me from across the field with that cycler rifle. And I don't know what the health bar of that turret looks like, but I'd hear one bullet dink off the turret, and then I'd explode. And it's like, what the, because that's all I hear. You just hear one little round, a cycler round go off, it hits you, and then you blow up.
Hey, hold up. Getting back to talking about pros, I do like the fact that, and I really do hope that that would carry over to the final build, but I understand if they actually add a sniper rifle into the game. The fact that everyone has the option of choosing that little cycler rifle, and that's like the only sniper rifle that you have. Like, that was pretty cool.
Everybody gets pretty much the same equipment pool.
Exactly.
You know, all you have to do is just buy your upgrades. Everyone's kind of uniform. Everyone's uniform throughout, and then all you got to do is just purchase the upgrades, and you can mix and match at least two pieces of equipment, and then I think one whatever that slot's called where the ion shot goes.
That's your special shield, something, I don't know.
Yeah, but, and then you got that, and then if I don't know if y'all got it, but there was that sharpshooter trait that you could equip, that you could buy and get.
I never actually made it to get to that damn thing yet. I was too busy buying everything else.
Well, yeah. Well, there wasn't really too much to buy, you know, being beta and all.
True.
So pretty, you know, after, you could probably get max level after one or two rounds, and all you have to do is just keep playing and earning money to buy the rest of the stuff. It didn't take too long.
But you can also save it, don't you, for when you get the game, you at least have the points already.
No. Right. I think they're wiping it clean, aren't they?
No, because you had to sign in with your account in order to play the game. So
yeah, but they can still wipe all the characters.
Oh no, but I'm talking about the points to use to buy the stuff. Don't you get to have
once you rank?
Yeah.
Well, that's up to them of whether or not they want to keep all the beta data. Because they could, like I said, they could still clean everybody's account. So when you next time you log in, when the game's officially released, you still, you know, you'll start over from scratch. It's not an early access where you can go ahead and join in and accumulate points. So when the game actually comes out, you know, you can be buying stuff the first time you log in.
That's right. Then why was they asking that for email address and other stuff?
What?
Yeah, they were asking for the email address and everything in order to log into their account.
Yeah, what game these days doesn't do that? Like when you're logging into some sort of service.
It's a beta. It's supposed to be free. Just test it.
You're playing on Xbox Live. It's not free.
Xbox Live free. Gold.
So that was, I guess, most of the pros. Anyone else have anything to say positive about the game?
No more quickscope. Yes.
Well, everything was quickscope.
No, but now you have to calculate in order to shoot. You don't have to aim and shot, and the dude's already dead, like in the other games.
Yeah, I saw plenty of blaster shots going right next to the guy's head. Nothing was counting as a hit.
Don't get me started on that.
Yeah.
Don't. We're saving that.
Yeah, but it's a good experience, because mostly it's a good experience based off the sound effects. They got that whole immersion thing going in. I think the random power-ups around the map that you could just pick up, because sometimes it could help you out in a pinch, but I didn't really see too much of that going on.
Survival?
Yeah, we'll get to it. Okay. The power-ups were fine. Vehicle play was good. The ability, well, if you could find it, you know, being the hero for a limited time. At least I kept that from the original. But those are the things I could really think of as far as, like, pros that I saw so far. Anybody else?
No.
Got the image, the graphics, and more of like a story-based, kind of like the way it feels.
Not really. Because, you know, we were playing Hoth. Mostly everybody was playing Hoth. I went and tried out some of the other game modes. Wasn't really too impressed, because Solus was like mostly all orange and black. And then Hoth was nothing but white. Yeah. So there's not really a whole lot of color contrast going on right there. That's why I wasn't really too impressed with the visuals.
Yeah, exactly.
Other than like the design of like maybe the vehicles and some of the character designs, you could tell everything was like smooth, looked good. But as far as the map layout, yeah, it wasn't all that great.
Okay. So yes, graphics were honestly, it looks honestly like Battlefield graphics wise. I can't say that that's a pro.
You know, like I said, it's just all solid white.
Now, that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the nitty-gritty of it. What did you not like about the game?
Accuracy. Way too easy to die. Lopsided fights.
Spawning issues.
Yeah. Two small maps.
There's literally one point on the Hoth map when I was playing Empire. I tried to flank around, and I kid you not, their entire team, rebel team, spawned in one spot. It would start off just one blip, like just blipped into existence, then another, and then they spawned off of them. It was 15 of them. I was just trying to shoot them, and the way that, you know...
You didn't kill it, and you didn't kill any of them?
I only killed one. Yep. I only killed one because they spawn with immunity. You have immunity when you spawn, so you can shoot them for your entire clip, blow your entire load, and not do any damage. It's horrible.
Yeah. Did you notice that too? It would take like an entire, I guess, overheat or whatever, to try and at least kill one person. Yes. I don't know how many times I would sit there and shoot at someone. My reticule was on them. And I was like 5 feet away from him, and I'd watch my bullet, you know, my little laser blaster, just barely, you know, skin next to their arm or next to their head. And then when I did hit them, it wouldn't do any damage. And then I'd fall over dead. Tick me off.
That happened more oftentimes than it needed to. I mean, they need to really work on this game about aiming down scope. Okay? It's not a competitive game in the slightest, just because you can't aim down scope. There's no skill required in this game whatsoever. You don't have to aim. You just need to move left and right and shoot.
Yeah, there's no bonuses whatsoever from aiming or not aiming. And it's even better to play in third person because you get a little few more degrees of visuals. And if you did aim... it slowed you down from whenever you were walking left and right. And there was no aiming bonus, at least that I could notice. So you were pretty much just walking around in third person, Gears of War style, just, you know, shooting people. And that was if you were lucky enough to, like, kill them. Because, like, sometimes I'd kill a guy in, like, two or three blaster bolts. And then the next time I'd sit there, be shooting at the guy, and I'd overheat, and he'd still have, like, a third of his health left. And then the only weapon that requires any aiming whatsoever is that cycler rifle. And if you don't get a headshot, you still don't, that's the only way you get like a one hit kill.
Yeah.
Because I've shot every time I got a body shot or a different, you know, arm, leg or whatever, it always take them down to 10% health. And then they would turn around, pew, 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 and I was dead. I'm like, what the fuck?
Melee sucks, though.
The what?
The melee.
Oh, God. I didn't even bother. All about that. I didn't even bother melee.
It takes, like, what, two or three hits to melee somebody and kill them?
Yeah. And it's slow, man.
It is slow.
And that depends on if you can get close enough to melee anybody.
Well, you pull up your energy shield, just run up to them and start hitting them in the face.
Oh, those are for the guys that have got the energy shield option.
Yeah. But, or you jetpack onto them. I did that a couple of times.
You actually, like, jump on them with a jetpack?
Yeah, you can't, like, do it like Mario style and crush their head by landing on them, no. But you just jump over them when they're shooting, and they come up behind them and hit them in the back of the face. It's awesome.
I've had plenty of times where the guys would, I'd be in a vehicle and they would try to walk right up to me and I'd just walk right over them.
I got crushed by the AT-AT.
Oh, that was your own fault.
It was. And I was on the Empire. I was freaking irritated.
Yeah, I killed Luke Skywalker, I think, in one of the first games I played that way. He tried to run up to me and melee the AT-AT. And I just kept getting free points for damaging him. And he just stood there until he died. I don't know if anyone else has seen this video of Luke Skywalker getting stepped on Hoth. He was like back. It was this one guy, one snowtrooper, who saw Luke Skywalker coming. He started running, backing up, shooting at him, taking pop shots where he could. And at the very last point before Luke could get his attack off to kill the guy, he didn't see the AT-AT. The AT-AT leg just comes in and just steps on him. And finishes them off. And they put music to it and all that, and everything came to a screeching halt as soon as he got stepped on. It was a hilarious video. But no campaign was another complaint I had. the missions that they have. Yeah, I know it was just easy, but it was way too easy. As far as the mechanics working for the game, as far as the beta testing, you know, everything seemed to work, but it just wasn't.
Yes, but
there's just no difficulty to it. You know, just
the gameplay is horrid.
Yeah, because you pretty much just run around the map picking them off as you run around in a circle.
And I mean, I don't like how cluttered the environments are. It's like, you remember the old Battlefronts? I mean, they were pretty straightforward and flat. Maybe a couple of obstacles in the way. But this here, what we've played so far, you're just getting nothing but terrain every fucking way. Sullust, forget about it.
Yeah, it's like they spent more time on developing the actual land.
But there's a difference between developing and making a map that is just covered with a bunch of terrain and making a map that's designed well.
Yeah,
because you have choke points out the wazoo on Sullust. Choke points out the wazoo on Hoth. There should not be that many choke points. You need to make it
especially if you get stuck inside the Rebel base on Hoth.
Oh, forget it.
Once they get close enough, you got guys pouring in the two hallway entrances, and then you got all the vehicles coming down the middle.
And the vehicles are trying to camp outside to create an opening for the Empire to get in.
Yeah. And Sullust felt like just trench warfare, because that's pretty much all it was like you're running down each path, or the walls are like anywhere from like 3 to 10 feet high, and then everybody is trying to jump up on top of, you know, get up on top of the rocks, and then as soon as you get on top of the rocks to get a better view, you get shot from another direction. And then when you're running in to capture some of the points, you've got all these crates and ships, and you got all this clutter everywhere, and you can only see like bits and pieces of your enemy. And then whenever you do run closer to try and get in there, you run into the accuracy blaster, or you overheat, and then you quickly get sniped, or you know, get shot by somebody else. So you're exposing yourself to try and get to the other guy.
Worse yet, you can't destroy any of that stuff.
Yeah,
make a nice, you know, clear view for yourself. Like in Battlefield, you can blow up pretty much the entire terrain, and next thing you know, you can shoot and snipe people from across the map with ease. You're not doing that in the Sullust map. You're not doing that on the Hoth map. You have giant fucking mountains and hill and snow mounds just everywhere. And that's not even adding the trenches.
Yeah, because you got the trenches with the negative terrain, and then you got all the hills. And I saw people throughout my entire experience trying to climb to every little single mountain, every little nook and cranny that they could get to, every vantage point, and you just watch them like snipe the crap out of everybody until someone figured out where they were, and then they would try and get up there. So it was just less people playing the objective.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's we're trying to keep in mind that it is beta.
Yeah.
Think about maybe they'll have like some form of open free-for-all map or conquest map, I don't know, when they have the final product, and maybe that'll be a little bit better.
Yeah, it just makes you a little worried of what the final product would be.
I am very worried about the way the final product is going to be, and that's why I'm just like, I'm not going to purchase it when it comes out. I'm holding off on it.
Yeah, that'd probably be a good plan.
I mean, we have Halo 5's coming out, so
Fallout 4 and...
You're going to lose me for a week when Fallout 4 comes out. Just throwing that out there. Getting back to Star Wars, though, I mean, another thing is just the power-ups. I don't like the way that they have that set up. I think they should have the vehicles just in the base somewhere.
Just have them. You just want them to have them. Well, yeah, because with the power-ups being scattered, they're a little bit more difficult to get to. Especially with like the, I remember seeing the X-Wings in the first round, you know, that first half.
Mm-hmm.
You have to run a pretty good portion towards the enemy in order to get the X-Wing icons. But most of the TIE Fighter icons, other than I think one, they're all pretty well covered.
Yeah.
It just adds to the difficulty for the Rebels.
And I think it added a little bit more to the immersion if you just actually try to take off. Like back in Battlefront 2. the throttle up a little bit, take off from the ship or take off from
I think they're trying to make Battlefront a little bit more user and casual friendly other than more hardcore first person shooters. So the hardcore people that really like playing these first person shooters are probably gonna do really well in Battlefront because some of the control schemes and, you know, just the mechanics have been so simplified. Yeah, that they're going to be able to join in, probably wreck shop with everybody. And the more casual people that are coming in just for the Star Wars experience are probably not going to have a very fun experience due to all the hardcore gamers. And that's probably where they should have put in the campaign, you know, so those casual players could at least go somewhere and still have their experience without, you know, a curse word coming out of their mouth every 5-10 seconds.
Rage and throw the controller.
Yeah.
Break the system. TV. No more game for the rest of their life.
I didn't feel like the maps were all that impressive.
But we did just play one map, though.
Well, I went and did Solus for a round. Wasn't really too impressed with that because it was pretty much the same thing. I'd go and run towards a capture point. None of my teammates were with me. I'd run in, get shot from behind from a guy on the other team that was going there. And by the time I would die, my teammates would finally start running up, and then they would get shot. And then, you know, it would just keep going back and forth, you know, with that crap. And like I said, you were pretty much just running in trenches, and then the only parts that would open up were when you were going in to capture the escape pod, and that's if you weren't already shot by a guy that like jumped on top of the rocks with a jetpack or something and sniped you from behind.
Mind you, it only takes like 2 shots to kill you.
Yeah,
it's like you are in relatively more technologically advanced than we are. I would expect the armor to at least do a little bit more protection. Like, how many shots does it usually take in most other first-person shooters to kill somebody?
Depends on their attack and defense values and all that.
Yeah, it depends.
Because in the movies, they shoot a stormtrooper or a rebel guy, and they'd all die in one hit.
But this isn't a movie. This is not a movie.
But they're going for the Star Wars experience.
Yeah. With no...
I'm surprised everybody wasn't doing that scream whenever you'd kill them.
They were! Are you fucking kidding me? I nearly died laughing for 10 minutes on one of the games. Everyone just kept dying and they kept screaming that stupid little scream.
Oh, they had that warg scream or whatever in there?
It wasn't the Wilhelm scream particularly, yeah. But it was just like that high-pitched...
I would notice that on occasion. They did do some of a little bit of a voice acting, you know, where they're like, "Oh, I need support. Oh, I can't hold it together." And then you hear the explosion, and yeah, you know, they'd have some of that intercom or, you know, walkie-talkie kind of chatter going back and forth on occasion.
Gosh,
I did like the implosion grenade. I did like the sound. I like lobbing that around and just listening to it go. You just have that bassy sound going on.
Well, yeah, it sounded kind of like, I guess, like a gravity bomb or some shit going off. Just, it was, you know, when that thing was fucking coming. Just put it that way.
And not to mention, once you got the thermal grenade, that's all you were doing was just chunking grenades because it was, you know, rechargeable. Just chunking. Pumpkin chunking.
Oh, yeah. I mean, don't like the power-ups. The controls are kind of clunky, too.
Yeah, well, like I said, all you had to really do was run around third person and just get somebody in your little targeting reticule.
Yeah, and then watch the shots go all around them.
So do you think they need to go back to the classes like they had in the previous versions where you could go and be a regular stormtrooper, a shock trooper, a rocket trooper?
Honestly, yes, because I don't know if you noticed, but with the way the weapon selection is set up, almost everyone was running around with a heavy machine gun.
Yeah,
because it's the best one.
Yeah, it had the fastest rate of fire and the fastest rate of cooldown.
Yeah, and it had the best accuracy as well.
I ran around with it too. I'd either run around with that or the blaster pistol, but the blaster pistol wouldn't work at a range, so I'd ended up just going with the machine gun, basically.
And that's my point. I mean, if you go back to the old class version, then not everyone's going to be running around with the same weapon. Right now, everyone's running around with the same weapon and practically the same equipment.
Yeah. No, that was another. Well, that was something with the old game, is you could only have so many troopers in each category, and then but you could have plenty of just regular stormtroopers. But if it was anything like what I was experiencing in this game, people would just be camping the same power. That's because that's what I saw. People camping the same power ups. You know, the same stations. They would go to the same spots, use the same equipment.
Alright. Zero, Venom, are you two going to get on this at any point?
Man, dude, I did terrible at it. I mean, I'm not really a big FPS. I've never really played Battlefield a lot. A couple times. But...
Well, this is a lot... Yeah, this is a lot simplified version of Battlefield.
Wow. Yeah, every time I spawn, I would just get killed.
Well, see, that's how I was at first when playing it, until I started learning at least how to work the game and play stuff, and then I got better at it.
No, the only time I did good at it was it was our last game. I like did my last game and dying too much, and then I killed like 20 people. I'm like, really? So I started again and I start dying again. And every single time I use the ships, I never kill nobody. And I lasted mostly half of the match.
Yeah, you're a pretty bad pilot.
I did learn how to fly though.
Yeah,
but when I learned, I got killed.
Yeah,
I feel like we should play some Foo Fighters, just for you.
Well, each side got three air vehicles, and if you could survive between the phases, you could add to your air force. But that's if you're you had three X-Wings up there. If those three X-Wings could survive the phase, they could stay in the air while the three A-Wings spawn. So then you could have up to six. If everybody could survive, which was unlikely because there was lots of kamikaze and BS going on, where people couldn't really fly or shoot all that well, so they would just crash into land vehicles.
That happened to me twice today.
they would try and crash into people on the ground, or they would just simply fly straight at somebody and, you know, crash into them in midair.
Well, I finally figured out that there was a throttle to that damn thing. It's like, that's why I kept crashing, because it's going full fucking speed, and by the time you realize, you're in third person, not first person, you finally realize, close to the ground.
You can switch to first person, just click down on the D-pad.
Oh, thank you for letting me know that. We still have time.
Yeah, because I sucked just as much as Venom did when we started playing and started flying, because I wanted to try and figure out how to fly.
Yeah.
And I would immediately on day one get shot out of the sky. I would spawn, because one bad thing I saw about it is as they're doing an introductory to you entering the battlefield in your starfighter, the enemy had time to get up behind you or at least get into position. So as soon as you got control of your starfighter, they would blow you out of the sky, because they'd already be on you. You'd be targeted. Because there's like a few seconds of when you pick up the power up, you activate it. It does this whole introductory screen where you're in whatever starfighter you chose.
Oh, that's another thing that pisses me.
You're flying into the battlefield and you can see the enemies coming at you, but you don't have control over your vehicle yet. And they're just swarming you. They're getting into position and getting ready to blow your butt out of the sky. And as soon as they're able to target you, if you were the only one up in the air, you had three rockets coming at you. And there was almost like very little time to react. And you at least got hit by one of those, if not all three. Because I ended up finding out I had to do that myself just to stay in the air. I'd have to go and, you know, because if I was distracted by any, like trying to shoot anybody on the ground, if I wasn't paying attention to the enemy starfighter spawn, you know, they would come out of nowhere, shoot me, and I'd be blown out of the sky within 2 seconds. It was, and that was pretty much how my first experience of being up in like an X-Wing, an A-Wing was. I get up in the air, I try and dogfight with somebody, I start shooting them from behind, and then all of a sudden, they would flip back, and then 2 seconds later, I'd be getting shot up the rear and blown out of the sky immediately. I think that happened to me like 3-4 times, and then I said, you know, just screw it. I'm just going to stick to the ground for now.
Yeah, best advice.
Get in the
eight. You don't know how to fly, crush with someone.
Yeah, that's the only way he would actually get a kill.
Or just crash into the AT-AT. I don't know how many times I saw that.
And then
I did that.
And it would never do.
Unless it shields us down.
Yeah, and it nothing. Yeah, it never did anything. I did destroy one of them by shooting him with 2 rockets, you know, from an A-wing. I ended up blowing one of them up. But that was the only time that, you know, there was very little people in the air. Went and found an A-wing, and I was actually finally able to play around with the controls and figure it out what everything did. I figured out how to throttle up, throttle down, you know, how to barrel roll, how to flip, how to do a 180 flip. First-person shooter, how to lock on, because you can actually lock on to the enemy vehicle as long as you can keep them within the reticule, and you can fire your blaster, and your blaster will shoot in their direction, so you don't have to. So your blaster doesn't just fire, you know, just it doesn't shoot straight. You can actually lock on and have your blasters, you know, shoot towards the person.
Wow.
Don't it sucks? It heats up those little lasers. The regular lasers.
Yeah, they heat up quick. No. I was always having, you know, the best thing I could do to try and get a few extra blasters off was I would just try and pulsate the trigger. But yeah, once I figured out how to actually control the fighter, you know, I figured out why I was getting my ass kicked out of the sky so much when I was first playing. And after that, I was dominating pretty good. And then, you know, occasionally I still get teamed up on, because if you're the only starfighter, you know, X-Wing, A-Wing, TIE Fighter, whatever, if you're the only one up in the air on your team, if there's like 2 people on the other team, you're going to get killed. You have to go up there with like a like 2 or 3 guys. That's the only way you're going to survive. If you're up there by yourself, you might be able to take one of them down, but the other two are going to be right on you. Because you can almost do a complete 360, you know, in spot. You're pretty much just flying in a very, very tight circle.
Because if you recommend to have the rebels with more airplanes, not just 2 or 3 kinds. Whoa. And fast ones.
Well, each phase had a different air vehicle.
Yes. Yeah, but the rebels, I seen they were pretty slow.
Well, yeah, the TIE fighters are built for speed and maneuverability. All the rebel stuff. Well, the A-wing's built for speed and maneuverability, but most of the other stuff's built to take a few hits, to, you know, take a beating. But not in this game.
No, again, that goes back to everything dies way too quick in this game, especially when you have a 20-on-20 size map. It's like that's 19 other people shooting at you.
Yeah.
And with all the guns and weapons and vehicles, you're gonna die quick. They need to beef up the health or lower the damage a little bit on some of that stuff, and add in the aim down scope.
Or add some more variety.
Variety, I guess.
But as far as the mechanics of the beta going, yeah, everything I guess was working as intended, other than like minute aiming errors. And if you ever looked up in the sky, you basically see everybody doing donuts, trying to shoot one another.
No, we never did that.
Yeah, that's pretty much, if you wanted to survive, you basically lock on to a guy and you would try and get on their butt and just do your best to stay on them.
All right, hold on. Okay, so Venom, what was your best moment?
My best moment, when I used Dark Vader. I was so happy, even though there was no people to kill. I had to walk all the way to the other side of the map.
I saw that.
And realized that when I did my first attacks, my time was off. But it was the greatest moment of my life. That was Dark Vader.
Hey, I was Vader earlier.
I didn't die. Nobody shot me. I was unstoppable. It'd be cool, there were people to kill.
All right, yeah, well, I was trying to say, I was Vader like twice a day. The first time, I actually ended up like force choking like 3 people, and then I just like killed like five people all at once, and I just went up there and just like started hacking at them and slashing on them. And then like later on, like towards the end of the game, I ended up being Vader again, but then I ended up getting killed like by someone just hitting me in the back.
Did it get stepped on?
No, I never did. I actually tried to get stepped on by one of those ads, but I didn't. It wouldn't even crush me.
I guess it only works if you're a rebel.
What about you, Kirby?
I ended up getting into the AT-AT earlier. Towards the end, where it's just nothing but that completely flat area right before the generator. Oh, I had so many kills, man. You can call it an orbital strike. You can shoot them with the turbo lasers. You can shoot them with just the regular lasers. There's nothing but bodies everywhere. And then the stupid Luke Skywalker tried to come and take me out. I blew his ass up with turbo lasers from across the map.
I found the best things on the ad. It's just the regular lasers.
Yeah, the turbo lasers you want to use if they get into a turret. If there's a turret shooting at you, just shoot that thing at it.
And but, the turbo lasers seem like vehicle weapons. I was lucky enough to shoot one A-wing out of the sky with that.
Oh, I was trying so hard to hit him with that damn thing.
I took advantage of the fact during one of those matches where it was a bunch of X-wings and A-wings, and they were just basically doing strafing runs where they were flying straight at the battlefield. You know, they weren't curving, they weren't doing nothing. They were just flying straight at the field, just doing, you know, strafing runs. So one of them tried to do it to me. And while I was in the AT-AT, he flew straight at me, and I fucking shot him in the face. And then I did tag a few of them with the cycler rifle.
Nice. I think that's about it, right? Just talking about the game.
Pretty much.
Now, are you guys ready to go play the game?
Yes. Let's get killed.
Maybe tomorrow evening.
Ah, oh, all right.
That'd be working like 7 hours.
What?
No. All I heard is excuses.
I know. I had to go work in 6 hours, and I'm still going for it.
No, thank
you.
Eat a dick.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been another dorkFish Labs production.
Eat it.
This is Kirby.
Eat it, Shadow.
And
zero. I do sound weird when I say
it. Hey, we're sounding out for the night.
Eat it, Kirby. Eat it real good.
Go fuck yourself.
Is that an offer?